Ladies and gentlemen, he fights out of the blue corner. He wears the black trunks. He stands 188 centimeters tall and weighed in at 76.9 kilograms. He comes to us with 18 wins, 14 big wins coming by way of knockout against only 8 defeats. He hails from Istanbul in Turkey. He is the former amateur Muay Thai world champion and former four-time professional world champion. Please welcome Atakan Avatar Arslan. And across the ring, he fights out of the red corner. He wears the red trunks. He stands 180 centimeters tall and he weighed in at 76.9 kilograms. He comes to us with 3 wins, 2 wins coming by way of knockout against 2 defeats. He is the Romanian Kyokushinkai Karate Champion. He comes from here, from the city of Constanza. Please welcome the hometown hero, the unanimous Alex Fili.
Well, what a matchup we've got here. I was just commenting that Atakan Arslan took all of 35 minutes to get into the ring. Alex Philippe danced into the ring, as you'd expect a Kyokushin fighter to do. No mess, no fuss, let's get on with it. So, 4 times world Muay Thai champion, Atakan Arslan. But he takes on Alex Philippe, the reigning Romanian Kyokushin karate champion. And I have to say, I might be a little bit biased in favor of Alex Philippe, purely and simply because he sampled some of my commentary onto his entrance music to get into the ring. But just look at this now, scheduled for 3 rounds, and right from the get-go, we've gone up a level here. At middleweight, you're going to expect the speed to be pretty lively, and Atakan Arslan has taken it upon himself to set the pace. Oh, reverse spinning back kick, but low. Ushiro Muwashigeri downstairs into that right leg of Atakan Arslan, and it hurt because he's backed off. Knee strike from Arslan. This is getting lively. Front teep from Arslan, and we're seeing some good work here. Good low kick there from Philippe, and this is classic old school. Oh, good punch to the midsection from Philippe, and Arslan felt that. He's the local boy here, Alex Philippe. And the referee, Cesar Jorge, called the break. And Atakan Arslan has not gone to a neutral corner, didn't break, put in a low shot. So Philippe brings up the high Muwashigeri. Covers up nicely, Philippe, but he's under pressure here. This is a sparky opening, but Cesar Jorge, referee, saying you can't pull on with the hands from the clinch. Good left-right combination and the high kick there from Philippe. But I have to say, Arslan replies in kind. Covered up well, Philippe, and he's under a lot of pressure here. That jumping knee strike, and Arslan trying to rough him up with the clinch. Got the height advantage here, Atakan Arslan. So he's using that to good advantage. But Philippe made a great crossover from the linear karate style. He's got great boxing skills here. Trying to work the inside of the calf there with the low kick, but Arslan coming back. This is high level work. Half a minute left, and both fighters know they're in a fight. And Alex Philippe is old school, he really is. You know, you squint your eyes and you think of Francisco Filho. Rolling thunder drop kick there from Alex Philippe. He doesn't land it, but we like the intent. even round. And both fighters still very much in this. This is going to be sparky. And not to detract from the other bouts, but this is sparky. So you know you've got to dig deep to put a Kyokushin practitioner out of it in stand-up, especially if they're useful. But what we're seeing here is a pure clash of styles. And just look at this. Atakan Arslan, the Muay Thai stylist, was an amateur champion, four times professional champion. And for many, many years, the argument has raged. Where did the K1 platform originate? Well, we know it originated in Japan from sport karate. And Kyokushin, the primary full contact style. But then, of course, Muay Thai added to it, boxing added to it. And it became very much a mixed martial art in terms of the amount of Kakutoga that was allowed to compete. So we're going back old school here, really. Really is a karate fighter facing off a Muay Thai stylist. Good left hand there from Philip. I have to say, Arslan is very impressive, but he needs a lot of gas to keep going here. What he's doing is energy intensive. Philip just come to the K1 platform. So a lot to learn here. And he's getting caught. Works the inside kick again. But Atakan Arslan starting to slowly get the edge here. Trying to work a strategy here, Philippe, but he powers in there, starts to land the shot, and that's because Arslan now starting to blow a bit. He's out of gas, and this is where the momentum could change for Philippe if he starts to put his foot down to the floor. Powering forward, marching forward, close the ring down, not giving Atakan Arslan room to operate, but they're both starting to blow now. And that. It reminds me of that old adage. When you're wrestling a bear, you don't stop when you're tired. You stop when the bear's tired. And that's a thought for Alex Philippe to think about. Starting to hold now, Philippe. Just under a minute left now. Both fighters have put a lot into this at this stage. I think Atakan Arslan has probably got the edge on every round so far. I think that's because Philip is trying to stop this, but he needs to really take the spring out of the legs of Arslan, which he's done. Arslan now starting to look just a little tired, but has Philip got the power left to finish the job? There's the jumping knee strike. He's never out of something spectacular, Atakan Arslan. Alex Philip now to dig deep here. First round, Atakan Arslan, I'd have to say. Second round, maybe by a margin, maybe a draw if I was generous. Philip needs something special here now. And I have to say, I think that round by a margin has gone. A very small margin to Atakan Arslan. We'll get a chance to examine it in the replay. Evening here, open air in Mamaia, Romania, on the coast by the Black Sea. So just look at the action here. Alex Philippe really had some good moments. Some of those shots really thundering in. Atakan Arslan. What a campaigner. Come here to do business. Maybe I'll give that round to Philip. One apiece, everything to play for. But I think Philip has to be much more convincing here. And that's a difficult task because the anatomy physics give Atakan Arslan the edge. So the third and final round in our third bout this evening. It's another super fight, super middleweight bout at under 77 kilograms. Atakan Arslan, the Muay Thai stylist, takes on Alex Philippe, the Kyokushin king of Romania. And, well, two styles on the line. Marching forward, Philippe. But he gets turned on the ropes by Arslan. Arslan has just slightly superior boxing skills, but the power from Alex Philippe really started to show in the second round. Can he keep things rolling through into the third? Both fighters really starting to blow. Low shot, Arslan takes a breather. All good, and that's a step kick, which is not allowed, foul of the rules. And this is good work from Philip. He powers forward, very linear, you can see, and he's turned again, and he's falling foul of the, well, I would say superior boxing skills of the Muay Thai stylist. But look at this in the slugfest, it's Philip that's landing the shots, and they're really, really bringing this. This is Philippe's hometown. I have to say, I think Atakan Arslan has to be really convincing here. It's a slip. When I say Atakan Arslan has to be convincing, it's because I could say that the home fighter might be favoured if it's close. But I have to say, I don't think it's that close. And I think Philippe needs to put a bit more effort into the work here. Oh, that was a rip-roaring left-right combination. Rocked the head back of Philippe. He's in trouble now. He needs to keep covered up because Arslan could finish this. And Philippe looking like a spent force here. Really struggling, half a minute left, and he could get sat down here. Philip needs to dig deep. Oh, big right hand, he's taken another one. How many of those can you take? It's a testimony to his endurance and strength, but not to his skill. Bangs out a right, Philip. Good performance from Arslan. Well, I have to say, Atakan Arslan put in a great, great performance there. And I'd be very shocked to see if he doesn't take it. He knows he's been in a fight. But Alex Philippe, having just made the transition, just maybe a little bit more to learn about avoiding some of those slipsy shots. High advantage that Arslan had was a factor here. But just towards the end, Philippe taking just a few too many shots. Well, both fighters in their corner, so I'm assuming that there's another round. So it was that close. And I said that. I said, when you come to fight a fighter on home turf, you've got to be convincing. I thought Atakan Arslan had done enough, but quite clearly not. It goes the extra round. Well, this is where these boys have to dig deep.
It seems we go to a fourth round.
So the judges couldn't decide it. And it doesn't look like anyone's that keen to go an extra 3 minutes. But this has turned out to be a Frankenstorm of a fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is a draw. We go to an extra round. That means the winner of the fourth round is going to win the whole contest.
So it's a golden round. It's all on the line here, and it's an opportunity for Philippe. Just a bout win on the line here. It's a clash of styles. So a fourth extra round. The first three were a draw. All that's gone before goes for naught. This is a golden round. Whoever wins this wins the bout. So for the fourth time, these two warriors meet in the ring. Atakan Arslan, in the black trunks of Turkey, takes on Constanta's local boy, the Kyokushin champion of Romania, Alex Philippe. Philippe boxes his way through this 3 minutes, he could win. What he doesn't want to do is headhunt, because if he exposes himself, Arslan has shown himself to be very mobile. Lovely inside kick there, took away the feet of Arslan. Arslan comes forward, it's the knee strikes that are really devastating, and Philippe. Well, referee Cesar Jorge having words there with the camp of Atakan Arslan. Just a little bit too much activity there from the corner men. And this is an opportunity for Philip, it really is. He needs to step up to the plate here. Trying to work the kicks, trying to take some juice out of Arslan. But this is a slugfest now, and both fighters running on air. We need a winner, we need to decide here. And Arslan, when he sees the opportunity, turns Philippe excellently. Philippe still too linear. Just over a minute left now. Who wants this? Fortune favors the brave. And one of these fighters has got to now put everything on the line. It's a slip. I think Philippe, very fortunate to be thrown a lifeline with this extra round. And again, holding with the clinch and putting the knee strike in. Very difficult for a Muay Thai fighter to make the transition to a three-round K1 format. Right, now, 30 minutes to go. The corner should be really driving these boys on. And that was sloppy work from Philippe, and you don't get any prizes for second place here. And what you need to see Philippe now is to use those kicks, maybe a high kick, something with a bit of flash in it to convince the judges. Well, I think Arslan has just won this now. On the 10-second clapper, Arslan has put the work in when it's been needed, and he kisses his glove, and I think he's done enough. Still got to wait for an official verdict, but absolutely spent Alex Philippe. And it's part of a learning curve, a sharp learning curve, to come from a traditional style into this format. Let's see how the judges scored it anyway. Can't take away the accuracy. Philippe landed some great shots. Kyokushin warrior there just putting the hands up to the temples and just standing there taking the shots because he can, but of course they're scoring. It's been an interesting verdict. Tense here while we wait to get the announcement. While we wait for the announcement, Christiana Loken, the star of Terminator, in attendance here tonight. Say star of Terminator, along with, of course, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Ladies and gentlemen, after an extra round, we go to the scorecard. The first judge scores the extra round for Atakan Arslan. The second judge scores the extra round for Alex Philip, and the deciding judge scores the extra round for the winner by split decision, the anonymous Alex Philip!
Well, Alex Philip takes the decision.
Alex Philip!
That's all I've got to say about that.
Alex, for you, this fight was really tough. I mean, like, tough.
Yes.
Maybe as you like.
No, it was my toughest fight because my opponent was a glory fighter, and I'm glad that I beat him.
I was a little bit afraid after the, you know, after the third one. I felt maybe he was very tight in the first, second for you, the third for him. I said maybe. I don't know what the decision, but you was a little bit afraid also, maybe.
It was a very good fight. Thank you, Arslan.
Congratulations, both of you, because it was a really tough fight, guys. Thank you very much for our attack.
Herkes maç izledi ve maç bizim. Everybody watch now. The fight is mine. Alex is a good fighter. Thank you for fight.
I have... Congratulations, guys. I have with me Christiana Loken, you know, best known for her role in Terminator 3 so far. What do you think about the show?
Oh my gosh, this has been so exciting. And I'm sitting next to the three-time ex-world champion, Remy, and he's teaching me so much about this sport. So I'm really enjoying myself. Very exciting.
What about your stay in Romania? Because you are so far from Hollywood here. So how is it for you in Romania?
I've been so enjoying myself. The people here are absolutely wonderful, very gracious, very warm. And I've shot a movie here 11 years ago, so I'm happy to be back in Mamaia.
Always a pleasure to see you. I think everybody's thinking the same here tonight, so pleasure to see you, Christiana, here. Thank you very much. Thank you. See you soon.